Vad händer om en kommun gör uppror mot staten? Det är oklart, för det här är första gången det händer.
The two southernmost counties in Sweden are Skåne and Blekinge. And this is the main stronghold of the Swedish Democrats. In the September 2018 local elections, they received roughly 20% in both of these counties. This caused many local leaders of the moderate party to break rank with their national leadership and form coalition governments with the Swedish Democrats in certain municipalities. Sölvesborg, which includes about 17,000 people, is one of these places. The new chairman of the municipal council is Louise Eriksson, who is engaged to party leader Jimmy Åkesson. Sölvesborg Municipal Coalition includes the Swedish Democrats, the Moderate Party, the Christian Democrats, and a tiny local party. The municipality is currently at the center of multiple major political controversies in Sweden. The Municipal Council is vowing to defy the Swedish government and refuse to accept any new economic migrants. Under a 2016 federal law, the government can assign economic migrants to municipalities and the local authorities must provide for them. They are not allowed to refuse. This is going to trigger a court battle. Even if the municipality loses in court, it will be a psychological blow against the left-wing Swedish federal government. It will cause months of embarrassing public debate over the issue. There are already other municipal councils who have said they are going bankrupt, providing for the economic migrants they have already received and simply can't afford any more. Sweden has a system where the individual municipalities are required to fund a lot of federal mandates with local municipal tax revenue. For several years now, an ever-increasing percentage of Swedish municipalities are having budget shortfalls. This is increasing tension between municipal-level government and the federal government. Then factor in that the current federal government is a minority ruling coalition that only received 33% of the vote. Also, in the past week, the Sölvesborg municipal government has done two things that are causing hysteria among the left wing and the media. The city has flown rainbow flags at the municipal building since 2013. A new law says only the national flag of Sweden and the municipal flag may be flown. The new guidelines say the city should not be flying any flags that promote a political agenda. They also passed new guidelines blocking city funds from being used to purchase and display so-called modern art. This has become a growing issue all over Sweden. For example, back in 2017, the city of Stockholm purchased and displayed so-called menstrual artwork at subway stations. They claimed the art promoted female empowerment. Many called it obscene and absurd. Under new guidelines, city funds can only be spent on traditional artwork that appeals to a broad majority of residents. Naturally, Swedish Cultural Minister Amanda Lind publicly denounced the move. A group of leftists retaliated by making a giant menstruating doll in Sölvesborg. The media and the radical left are now demanding that the leadership of the Moderate Party and the Christian Democrats condemn their own people who have formed coalitions with the Swedish Democrats. The leadership of the Moderate Party within Blekinge County is even deeply divided. Sölvesborg is also where the Swedish Democrats hold an annual festival every August. This event has repeatedly featured Swedish rock band Ultima Thule. The 2019 event also featured Tommy Ekman, a Swedish pop singer from the 80s. All right, thanks for watching this video. Click the like button. Post a comment below and tell me what you think about this. And please support my sponsor, Patriotic Flags, the online flag store, patriotic-flags.com. They're having a big sale right now until midnight Friday. Get yourself a Swedish flag. And please consider making a donation to this YouTube channel, as YouTube has mass demonetized all my videos. And I would like to thank Rush for making a donation. And click the subscribe button. New video every few days.